I'm Pepper Jack Jones.
Christian Blake.
Nice to meet you, brother. This is Life in a Headlock. The thing is, I'm asking a series of questions. You answer to the best of your ability. I do not edit, so if you screw up, hello YouTube, screw up.
Oh no. What do you... I don't need that.
Alright.
Botchamania?
Possible.
That's a plug right there, I guess, too.
Put it this way, last time I interviewed two people and I accidentally deleted both my damn interviews, so yeah, I botched it too. All right, first question is, who trained you to be a professional wrestler?
I would give credit to two people. There was a guy that was locally where I was from who had trained with the late Junkyard Dog, and then from there went over to Roddy Mack and Jazz whenever they were stationed in Church Point, Louisiana.
The little bitty building that had like the paintings on the side?
The paintings on the side and the cutoff and the ceiling just to put a ring in and have people stand on the top rope to do some high risk moves. Yeah.
Sweet. Well, how hard was actual training? Was there anything you had major difficulty with?
Well, the first thing, this is kind of embarrassing now to think about it, but I mean, back in the day, you didn't really realize, but clotheslines. I wouldn't be able to take a clothesline. It was just the timing, and it was uncomfortable, something you're not used to doing. I think that was the only thing when I started was the problem I had. Yeah, clotheslines. Short arm, long arm.
Well, it's this, how did you get your name for professional wrestling, or is that your God-given name?
Well, my real name is Blake Lemaire. Full name Christopher, and the middle name is Christopher. So, I couldn't really go with the real name things. Well, Christopher Blake sounded good, but then I couldn't do Blake Christopher because then it kind of sounded like Ryan Christopher or whatever. So I was like, well, let me try to shorten up Christopher to Christian and then just use my first name. And it clicked. And the funny story about that name, too, is a lot of people ask me nowadays if it's pronounced Exchian, because that's how I sign my autographs and that's how you see on t-shirts, whatever. But I go and tell them, like, kind of Christmas, they say Xmas. So hopefully this video would clarify that, yeah. It's not Exchian, it's Christian.
I thought it was Zeitin.
See, there you go. All right, and that's the first one I've heard.
And he's a promoter, so yeah.
That's it.
Let me ask you, who inspired you to get into professional wrestling? Was it somebody personal? Was it a wrestler?
It was a wrestler. I was big into wrestling when I was young. I'm 30. I was born in mid-80s. So, you know, WrestleMania started coming around. Hulkamania, I was a big Hulkamaniac. Whenever the time of getting into it, like having that interest was, I want to say it had to be Bret Hart, and what put the nail in the coffin was Bret Hart versus Steve Austin at WrestleMania 13. That was, to me, a complete, perfect WrestleMania match.
Push out with blood all over his face.
Right, everything made sense, and it right there drew me, so yeah.
Because everybody said like their favorite match is like Steamboat, Savage, and I go with the
well, Austin and you know what? I, as far as all time, yes, Savage and Randy, but I was, at that point, yeah, I was young, yeah. So, you know, but what caught me was at that moment of time was Austin.
To me, like, that one told a little bit more story because it was like a turn of a good guy and a turn of a bad guy.
Right.
I like that one just because it told so much
exactly.
More.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, what was your favorite match from TV? It could be pay-per-view, any federation, doesn't matter. Is there one like you go back and study yourself?
I've been fought for the past couple of years. My favorite has been New Japan Pro Wrestling. Anything with Nakamura, I enjoy. His battles with Tanahashi, I think, are like my favorites.
I watch a lot of YouTube.
Yeah. Right.
Cool. All right. Well, what is your favorite moment from professional wrestling? Do you have one?
Like some words that probably hit home. Probably my biggest moment had to be winning a championship title in front of my hometown.
Oh, not for you.
Oh, I'm my bad.
I'm sorry.
Like from like Hogan Slam and Andre or something.
Oh, Biggest Movie in Professional Wrestling.
Yeah, yeah. Got
you.
I'm getting to you here in a minute.
Man. Recently, Lesnar versus Taker breaking the streak. WrestleMania. I mean, that's...
Would you learn?
I wasn't because it felt fishy. You know, I regret it. But I had friends that were there, and they texted me, and they were like, these people are about to riot. They're throwing stuff. And it just, it was like a pin drop. Like, that's all you can hear in the whole stadium. It's like, wow, man. And I regret it because I missed that moment. Because I've never seen Undertaker live. So it's like, ah. But yeah, I think that was the biggest moment that I witnessed.
Okay, cool. All right, now I don't know what you were getting to a second ago. What is your favorite moment in wrestling for you?
Winning a championship belt in front of my home crowd, in front of my kids, my family. Aside that is, I think, just being in front of a crowd, like a wrestling town. Home is very, very, like, true to my heart right now. I've been there for about a year and a half, and I've went through countless obstacles along the way. Had my first steel cage match in July, and against Dirty Eddie Dalton from Texas, and that to me was the moment that kind of brought me up higher than where I was before. So yeah, cool.
All right, but that kind of hits on my next question. What is your favorite match you've been in?
Anything with Eddie Dalton.
Anything.
Probably see you dirty.
Is that like an ongoing storyline that y'all?
It was. We had a good year. I got injured last October, AC separation, so it kind of backtracked it for another 2 or 3 months. So we only had maybe 3 matches, and it was enough, you know, to put out there and bring it out for the home crowd and wherever we were at with it. But yeah, my favorite matches alone were with Andy Dalton.
Okay, cool. Let's see. Give me one wrestling story, a funny one, sad one, personal.
Well, I mean, there's certain things like when I got hurt last year. I guess it's funny. To me, it was funny. We had a emergency room right across the street. I knew something was wrong. I landed straight on the shoulder.
Which one?
This is the left one. They'll probably see it later on, they never noticed before, but it's like this. I don't know if I can try to.
Let me see the little bump right here.
AC separation, grade 3. So I was out for 2 months. But we walked across. It was funny watching the nurses trying to take off my gear because everything was just taped up, tied off. So that was another like struggle. But the funniest moment to me was being all drugged up and witnessing Roddy Magruder's reaction in the show. He rode with us. He's carrying my bags. And I'm all loopy, and I'm thinking to myself, like, this can't be real. Like, I'm thinking I'm hallucinating. That's Roddy Magruder. Well, no, dude, give me my bags. And he just, I mean, he was helpful, you know?
Yeah.
He's a really great guy, man. That's one funny story that I find is just,
like I told a guy.
Surreal, you know? It's like, this guy's like a
it's not if you get hurt, guy. And it's when you get hurt.
Right. So, that's one, it's funny to me. I mean, it might not be funny to people watching this, but.
That is a personal story, that's all I
right, was. Right, right. And I mean, that's a few, but I think it might be certain, like, kind of PG.
Yeah, I go kind of all over the place.
Right, I mean,
but I always
it's the stories I hear from other people, too, and it's like, man, I kind of just, I go with the flow with a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I'm here, it's wrestling, you know. So
that's what I prefer a personal story. That's cool.
No, that's cool. Maybe next time I can give you a good one, you know.
Well, that's fine. I'm not too many people get their shoulder knocked out of joint.
So. Well, yeah, that's one. And the thing is about that, I get hurt, and I'm telling the guys, I'm rolling out, and the ref's just oblivious, like doesn't know what's going on. I'm outside, my partner's there. He's like, "Come on, come in." I had to, it was so painful to sit on the apron and roll back in. And I'm like, take it home. He gets in, they go for another 5 minutes. And I'm sitting there like, what are they doing? I'm looking over to the guy that was sitting by the like the cameras and stuff. I guess it was a commentator. He couldn't take a hit. Rev couldn't take a hit. So finally, somebody from the back was at the curtain, looked at me, and all I had to do was just do this. And they sent everybody out.
You hunched over like Notre Dame, and they don't know what the hell's going on.
That's right. And I'm thinking it's out of socket, maybe, you know, dislocated or whatever. I'm trying, but I couldn't. It was so much pain. But it just finished, you know, like, hurry up. 5 minutes later, it's still going on. And you know what? The crowd was all paying attention to me, the 15 people that were there for that show, mind you. And I just didn't get it. And then the match happened, pinfall. We won. It was for the tag belts. It was vacant. Put those guys over. No, finish the match. We win the belts. Guess what? You gotta relinquish the titles anyway. 5 minutes after.
Well, I'd say this. At the time, they didn't realize you were that screwed up, right?
But I guess not. You know, I mean, I couldn't really do this.
He's like
but,
Mr.
I mean,
Fantastic
it's like,
from the Fantastic Four. But
that's right.
Well, let's move on. What do you think of TV wrestling? The good of it and the bad of it? Do you got an opinion?
I'm still appealed by it. Like, I enjoy it. You know, I watch it religiously every Monday night. You know, I have kids too that they starting to get into it. So the storytelling is kind of weak. I find that's a little bit bad for it. They got a lot of great talented guys and now that's there and it's just like, man, what are y'all doing with this? As far as I think their matches itself has been better than I've seen in the past couple of years.
I agree
with that. I really like TNA. I can't say much about that. I've kind of lost touch of that since they moved off to Spidey TV. You know, this is just Ring of Honor. I'll catch that. And I mean, it's kind of stuff that I'm into. You know, the hybrid, and then you have the strong style. So I try to watch every blend of it. You know, so. But most of it I enjoy. I mean, I can't really, other than maybe a few like Divas matches.
Yeah, I'm sure.
You know, that don't belong in there, and it's like, man,
I'll watch this show for just a minute.
Yeah.
Because I only get three anyway, so.
That's right. Okay.
All right. Well, if you could wrestle one wrestler from any company at any time, who would it be and why?
Nakamura. Somebody make it happen one day, please.
Well, here's
that's the, like my bucket list.
Why?
Strong style. He's the man. He's like people like to refer to him as like the CM Punk of New Japan wrestling or whatever. He's just cool, man. He's got a lot of like arsenals in him. His style, he's swag. I mean, everything. You know, I think it's one of those wrestlers that I would love to be in there to not only to just have that chance to be in the ring with, but to learn from, you know. So, and that's the majority of it. It's just that knowledge.
Okay, that's cool. Well, who is your favorite company to wrestle for?
Oh, that's not fair.
So, man, you can not, okay, you can go right? 1 through 3. You can give me 3.
Oh, man. Well, then if I go 1 through 3, even though it's not, you know, like a top, it's still like a wise, you know. That's like MySpace.
Okay,
you remember how MySpace was?
Is there a company you prefer to work for more than anybody else?
He said anyone that books him. That's
yeah, hey, anybody that books me, you know. You know? I'm really digging NWA Elite. We've got tons of talent there. Locker room is legit. You know, everybody's helping one another improve. We got leaders in there, you know. Voodoo Wrestling. In West Wego, they brought me in for a couple of years and never done me anything wrong, you know. And they got a bunch of group of guys there too that are hungry. They want to perform. They want to entertain. I'm trying to think of another one.
I didn't say bury the worst company, you know.
No. Like the good qualities are the ones that I like working
yeah,
for.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think that the most energy I put into lately has been NWA Elite because it's brought me more of a broad, you know, just I guess exposure and just giving me the, they've given me more
trust in, here's the tools, go out there and
paint us a real pretty
make us some money, you know, put butts in the seats. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I can say that I've done it so far, you know, I haven't really failed them yet, so.
That's cool. That gives my answer, I thank you. As a fan, what is your favorite kind of wrestling? Strong style, lucha, southern? Do you have one?
I favor a lot of the mixture of things, but mostly strong style. I kind of live that with the gimmick I go through, like with my tights. You're gonna see that strong style on the left side. It's kind of like a homage to it. But yeah, I'm really big on strong style.
Let me ask you. This isn't in my question, but I'm just curious. Do you mind the? A strong style?
The snub?
Yeah.
And tight?
Yeah. Or do you like it?
Well, yeah, I like
it. Well, some people complain about it. I like it.
I like to see or feel some contact, mm-hmm. you know, because then it wakes me up. Yeah, it makes me know. I mean, I don't know if we're talking about, I've got two stories about snub and not snub.
You can give me one, that's fine.
Okay, well, I wrestled Jim Mahal, Lone Star Championship Wrestling in Texas. And he was, beside like Roddy Mag, former WWE guy that I had a chance to work with. Mm-hmm. And right when that bell rang, it was different. Like, I wasn't expecting it, but it was like, boom. And I'm thinking, like, do I owe this guy money? Do I owe anybody backstage money? Did I step on the wrong toes? And I enjoyed it, you know? But it wasn't something I'm used to, because like you said, there's a lot that don't come at you. And it's like, come on. And I mean, there was this other guy I worked with, and he chops me, and he's like, this. And I'm like, damn. Then it does the second time, and he missed. So, of course, I had to, this is how you do it, buddy. Wow. Cool. I have that and there's a few people that says I have that reputation of being a little bit too stiff, but.
There's something about that, so I understand. Yeah. Well, would you rather wrestle as a heel or a face? Do you have an option? Mm. If so, why?
I like to think a different. I guess it goes by where I'm at, certain places. Nowadays, it's kind of hard to be a heel because. You're gonna have people that like the heels, mm-hmm. so it's hard because you don't want to get to that cool heel because that I don't like cool heel. You know, there's a lot of people that are like that nowadays. I would prefer to work face if it's close by. I guess it would make sense if it's like a local,
like your hometown,
right? Gotcha. Anywhere around a 45-minute. Because, you know, to me, it gets confusing when you go and you have people that travel and watch you, and like, from one promotion, you're a heel, and then 30 minutes down the road, you're a face, so it's like, eh.
Yeah, because it doesn't make sense.
And some promotions do that, and especially Louisiana, it's kind of like, eh.
Yeah, we're not their promotion, we don't care what they're doing.
Well, it's just, yeah, and it's like, well, it's like 20 minutes, 30 minutes down the road, like, you know, you have some guys that are in NWA Elite that are,
well, to me, that's how it's kind of what you're talking about. You're a heel there, but they're cheering you because you're a face down the road.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Well, and that's the thing. When I started in NWA Elite, I came in as a heel. And then what happened was it started catching on. People started getting behind me. And then they were testing the waters. Mm-hmm. You know, it wasn't like you're a heel, go out. It was just like, just go in, do what you got to do. Feed what the crowd's giving you.
Yeah, see, I like that myself.
You know, and I'm a new guy, so they never really, you know, so they're not gonna like me. They're gonna like the boys they've been seeing for a year there. So I was cool with that. Did my thing, and then it just started progressing. It started catching on, and then it was like, whoop, switch around, and babyface, and some claim I'm the number two over there right now, behind John Saxon. So.
See, I like that when they stick you out there, and they really tell you to be a face or be a heel, just go out there, and we'll see what the crowd thinks of.
Right.
And you go from there. Because to me, it's a more natural feel.
It's a natural feel.
Well, outside of wrestling, do you have a hobby at all?
I'm into right now, like web designing, video games. I haven't really been doing a lot of sports other than just wrestling. That's pretty much like my hobbies that I'm more into.
Okay. That's been done. I'm just curious.
Yeah, I know.
Well, let's see. Who is your favorite person to wrestle and why? I think I already asked you this.
But I mean, I can name another guy. It goes by the name Trucker Jones. We had started working together about 2 years ago, and then we ended up tag teaming together. So it's pretty cool that we had that chemistry going in where we're against each other, and then we became a tag later on, and we were doing pretty good. So I mean, I think he's one of the other favorite guys that I enjoyed working with the past couple of years.
I got a question that isn't written down. I want to ask this before I forget it because I just made it up the last interview. You yourself, do you prefer to wrestle as a tag team or singles?
I guess singles. But I got in this situation of like how the tag team divisions have been. Especially like locally, it was very low, and they would just throw people together. So like that, and that's how like me and Trucker got together. We did Team Strong Style. We were both interested in like Strong Style. We were interested in New Japan, so we're like, hey, let's bring it over here, you know. And we had a good like run with it. I enjoyed it for like the year and a half that we were tagging. But I guess like singles, I guess it's more or less like it's you out there.
Yeah.
You know, not to have an ego about it, but it's like, you know, you want to put out what you can do and show everybody what you can do.
Well, to me, you always got to brag about yourself because ain't nobody going to talk good about yourself. You know what I mean? Not always.
Not always, but, you know, I guess that's one of the good qualities I have, where I'm just not one of those that too small to warn. All
right. Let's see. What is the move you use to finish off most of your opponents, and what is it called?
To a running knee, made famous by Nakamura, so he calls him Mama Ye. I still haven't really came up with a name. I kind of let the commentators that like do call the shows, especially Elite. I don't know if they call it the Game Changer because that's what I go by as the Game Changer. I want to say it's the Game Changer.
I like that,
but cool. Yeah. So. That's my main finisher right now is the running.
Well, that's the final question. And it's who's been there on a professional level, and if you'd like to thank them, here's your opportunity.
Wow. On a professional level, even on a personal level, I want to say Battle Boy John Saxon. Gave me a chance a year and a half ago for NWE, and it's. Like I said, he's giving me the tools, he's pushing me. I mean, they even joke about me being the second coming of John Saxon, which I find pretty hilarious. Not you know, against him, but, you know, I want to be Christian Blake, you know. So, but right now, as far as my success in this goes on a professional level, he's top on the list. Not because he's a booker in the NWA or anything like that, but, I mean, he's really that guy that you can always go to for like after your match, like, hey, what can I do better? And he'll tell you straight up, shoot, you know, like more fire, you know, hey, I want you to go watch Jerry Lawler, I want you to go watch Ricky Morton, see how these guys sell the baby face, you know, like stuff like the small things, you know, I mean, just that opportunity, man, he opened the door for me. And I mean, from how it's looking, you know, I'm wrestling Steve Anthony next month. You know, he's putting a lot of faith in that. And the thing is, it's a face versus face, you know. And Steve Anthony is, you know, one of those, they call him the secret of the South, you know what I mean?
I know a lot about Steve Anthony.
Everybody knows about Steve Anthony. WWE knows about Steve Anthony. New Japan knows, you know. So
yeah, I like the opportunity to use him in that show. Him and his family in the front row. And I was like, really?
Hey, I had my head down.
But it was still cool.
I had my head down, and I looked up, and I thought I was like, that split second that he cut him off, and I'm like, man, was that Steve on TV? It's kind of ironic.
That was weird. I was like, everybody else, I think they were like pulling Lesnar and Taker apart. I believe that's when it was, but I'm not positive. But
probably so.
I just remember that. I was like, brother, I appreciate you being on Life in a Headlock. It seems like you got everything pretty cool. Your headlock's pretty loose. Got life in control at least a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, bro. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, man.
I appreciate it.
All right.
Oh, let me kill this off. I'm going to focus the camera.